Welcome to the demonstration of NetSuite Cash 360. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how the Cash 360 dashboard and Cash Forecast portlet provide both visibility into near-term cash flows, as well as easy-to-use preference drivers to build cash position forecasts. I'm logged in as my default controller role. In this scenario, I am tasked to provide management with a three-month cash forecast to ensure there's adequate cash on hand to meet company commitments and objectives. First thing I'll do is navigate to my Cash 360 dashboard. Opening up the dashboard in a new tab, I have one view of my complete cash position. Here on the dashboard, I can see account balances such as my bank balance, my receivables balance, as well as my accounts payable balance. I can also see a weekly activity table of my cash inflows against my cash outflows. Based on preferences I've set up in the system, I've developed a forecast on a weekly basis. With the dashboard, I can see a visual representation of this forecast over time. Additionally, on the dashboard, I can see some visualizations of my AR and AP aging summaries. With the interactive graph, I can clearly see how 80% of my AR aging is 90 days plus. I can also get an idea of the transactions making up the balance as well as the customers. On the AP side, I can drill into my current balances. I can also see the total vendors as well as transactions making up the $1.8 million AP balance. The Cash 360 dashboard also includes an action section with quick links to listings such as my AP bills or my AR and AP aging summaries. I'm able to quickly execute on actual transactions and drill down to take an action on either paying or receiving bills. I can also have quick access to my aging summaries with drill down capabilities. This helps me in my analysis as I'm re-forecasting our cash. As we look to our cash forecast and our preferences, I'm tasked to looking at a three-month forecast versus a weekly forecast. I also have some inputs to update my forecast with in a minute. Based on my forecast table, I can see my weeks laid out for me across time. I can also see my cash inflows and my cash outflows. I also see my closing balances. I have direct links to those particular records as well. Going to my preference tab, I'm able to update my forecast period from weeks to months. I'm also able to add additional values, such as rent and repairs for a new lease we have coming up. In this case, I had a forecast starting on 12/1. Let's move that forecast up. See if we can take the space on earlier. Also have an increase in cost. The monthly rent is $5,000. What type? It's an outflow, it's a cash outflow. I have it recurring 12 times once per month. Going back to my account categories, I have commission expense here. As I know, I'm gonna be paying out more commissions over time. Currently in my forecast, I'm using the last 6 months of data as an average and a movement of 20% increase. As I know, we're looking at our comp plans and increasing commissions, I'm gonna increase this movement to 50%. In saving these changes, I should be able to reflect a new cash forecast. Navigating back to my cash forecast table, I'm now able to see my 3 months versus the weeks. I'm able to see my rent and repairs adjustment starting in the month of November, $5,000 a month, as well as that uptick in commissions expense. So as you can see, from a few clicks of a button, I'm able to visually update our cash forecast from weeks to months, as well as incorporate some additional values. Through the graphs, I'm able to continually see these visuals and see the trending line across time. Thank you for watching this demonstration. If you have any questions, please reach out to your account manager.